ladies. On behalf of the Australian Shareholders Association, I'd like to welcome you to your own online financial literacy workshop. I'm Felicity Cooper, and as winner of the Financial Planner of the Year with the FPA and also with Money Management, as well as being the owner of a financial planning practice on the Gold Coast, it's been my absolute honour to have travelled with the Australian Shareholders Association across the country presenting this to a group of women. We've had such great feedback from the ladies that attended these, as well as feedback that they wished it could be more accessible, that it was decided to make it into an online format for you to go through at your own pace. What we found from the presentations was that the people doing these workshops had really different levels of confidence and experience. It's important to know that these workshops are made to give you a basic level of understanding so that you can have more open conversations about money. They certainly don't replace individual advice, and if you want that or want to continue the conversation to see how it might apply to you personally, please make sure you see a financial planner. The reason that we're doing this is because we've found that typically women don't talk nearly as much about money as men do. In fact, when we look at the reasons for why women invest and do things with money compared to men, they're completely different. There are actually studies that look into this difference between female and male investors. Males tend to invest as hunter-gatherers. They typically take a little more risk and are more performance-driven. For women, we usually make big money decisions with a bit of a fear driver behind them. We often look at our finances from a question of, what happens if this happens in my life? Will I have enough? What happens if something happens to the kids? What happens if my partner passes before me and I'm left with all of this? How are we going to afford our home? Can I really afford a new car? Or will I run out of money? We also don't talk about money as much as men do. When we did the live session, we found that many women really haven't had open conversations with anyone. A lot of this came from the way they were brought up. You know, it's a taboo topic. You don't really talk about sex, politics, or money. It's just rude. If you put a group of men on a golf course, they'll usually talk about money. You know, what are they buying? What tip do they have? How much does something cost? Women, if we go to lunch or coffee, do we talk about money? No. So from that point of view, just that basic literacy that we have in terms of understanding finance, we've been at a disadvantage because we just don't talk about it as much. So from a financial literacy point of view, we're going to have a bit of a talk about why we don't talk about money, which we've already started doing, and why it's so important for you to understand your current financial position at the moment. The fact is, somewhere along the way, like 90% of women, you're going to be solely responsible for your money. Either it's at the beginning of life, before you've got a partner, because we are marrying older, or somewhere along the way we get divorced or separated, or at the end because we live longer. So at some point it's going to be on us to look after our money. So it's really important for us to feel comfortable taking control of our own financial situations and knowing how to deal with your funds. It's really sad, but studies have shown that 61% of women would rather talk about their own death in explicit detail than talk about money. 80% of women don't want to go and see a financial planner. Only 60% of women don't want to go to the dentist. So not only is it that we'd rather talk about death more than money, we'd rather go and have our teeth pulled than go and see a financial planner or someone to talk about our money. So there's a real fear with women about actually going and talking to someone and having these open conversations. The feedback that we got was that we don't feel as though we know even where to start. We don't know what questions to ask, and we're often scared that we won't know the answers to the questions that we're going to be asked. So hopefully that's what this does, is to give you some of the tools to talk to someone, whether it's your accountant, a financial planner, your banker, or your partner about money in a more informed way, where if nothing else, you know the questions that you want to ask, because sometimes we don't even know where to start. So even if we just give you the questions you want answered, it already gives you more than perhaps you've got at the moment. Now there is a workbook for you to download, which I suggest you go and do, because we're going to use that through the videos. So probably print that before we get started. Before we even go to the next video though, I want you to take 5 minutes and write down, probably at the back of the book, what's your biggest concerns when it comes to money? Everyone has something, and it's really good to get some clarity about what your main drivers are so that you can look for the information that's going to be most helpful to you as we go through the videos. And once you've done that, I really look forward to seeing you on the next video.